Hello everyone, and welcome to Sine of Our Time. My name is Bruce, and today I want to dive into a synthetic division problem in which there are certain powers of x that are missing from the dividend, which, as we can see from the Sine-meter, is just a tad bit spicy. Now, if you're learning about synthetic division for the first time, well, then I recommend that you check out the first video in the series by clicking on the link above. We start by noting that the divisor is of the form x minus b, meaning that the coefficient of x is 1. Now, this is important in order for synthetic division to work. If the coefficient of x is not equal to 1, well, then it becomes a whole lot more complicated. But more about that in the next video in this series. Next, we ensure that the dividend is written in descending powers of x. That just means from the highest exponent of x down to the lowest exponent of x, which it is in this example. And then we scan the dividend to see if there are any missing powers of x. And in this example, there is a missing x cubed term as well as a missing x term. So let's just put placeholders into those positions, which is essential in setting up the synthetic division. Now let's begin by writing down the synthetic division symbol. And at the top, on the left, let's write down the value of x that makes the divisor equal to 0. And since the divisor is x plus 2, the value of x that makes that equal to 0 is, of course, negative 2. And then on the inside of the synthetic division symbol, at the top, we write down the coefficients of each of the terms in the dividend, placing them in imaginary columns. Okay, please, please, please listen to me. It is extremely important to write down those 0 coefficients of the x cubed and x term. Because if we do not write them down, then our synthetic division process will not give us the correct answer. Trust me. And to complete the setup, we take that 5 and we bring it down and write it below the synthetic division symbol. All we have to do now is repeat those 2 very simple steps, which are multiply and add. And it's really as simple as that. So let's do it. Step 1, multiply. We take the negative 2 and we multiply it by the 5 in order to give us negative 10, which we write one column over below the 0. And then step 2, add. We take 0 and we add negative 10 in order to give us negative 10, which we write below the synthetic division symbol in the same column. Now we just keep on repeating those same steps. Step 1, multiply. We take the negative 2 and we multiply it by the negative 10 in order to give us positive 20, which we write one column over beneath negative 32. Step 2, we add. We take the negative 32, we add 20 in order to give us negative 12, which we write in the same column below the synthetic division symbol. And back to step 1. Multiply. We take that negative 2 and we multiply by negative 12 in order to give us positive 24, which again we write one column over beneath the 0. And then step 2, add. We take 0 and we add 24 to give us, of course, 24, which we keep in the same column and we write below the synthetic division symbol. And again, step 1, multiply. We take negative 2 and we multiply it by positive 24 in order to give us negative 48, which again we write one column over beneath 50. And then step 2, we add. We take that 50, we add negative 48, which gives us 2, which we write below the synthetic division symbol in the same column. And that's all there is to synthetic division. The first 4 numbers at the bottom of the synthetic division symbol represent the coefficients of the quotient, while the last number under the synthetic division symbol always represents the remainder of the division. Now, Since each term of the dividend is always divided by x in the divisor of x plus 2, the corresponding term in the quotient always has a degree 1 less. So what I mean by that is the highest term in the dividend had a degree of 4, which means that the highest term in the quotient will have a degree of 3. And as a result, the quotient is going to be 5x to the power of 3 minus 10x squared minus 12x plus 24 with the remainder of 2. As always, we can write the results of the division in the same way that we have done in the past. In closing, synthetic division is still a quick and easy method to divide polynomials even when there are missing powers of x in the dividend. If you feel you have the hang of this, then please try out this problem and let me know what your answer is in the comments below. And if you enjoyed this video, please let me know. Now, this is not the end of synthetic division because we have not yet considered what to do when a divisor is of the form ax plus or minus b. But more about that in the next video in this series. Well, that's all from me, and I want to say a very big thank you for watching.